Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for the 2020 NBA champion Los Angeles Lakers. And to kick things off today, I've got two words that will make you cringe. Basketball reasons. That's right. We all remember way back when Chris Paul was almost traded to the Los Angeles Lakers. It was a done deal. And then it wasn't. The dearly departed David Stern vetoed the trade, sending Chris Paul to the Lakers from the New Orleans Hornets at the time. And unfortunately, when that unraveled, he then later on got shipped to the Los Angeles Clippers. And so the Lakers had to watch Chris Paul playing for the other team in LA. Might that ancient wrong be righted finally? Well, according to Eric Pincus of Bleacher Report, we could be headed in that direction. I want to break it all down, what a Chris Paul trade for the Lakers would look like. But first, quick reminder, do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring the notification bell so you get notified when we go live like we are going to do tonight, October 15th. We're going to go live at 9 o'clock Pacific time. Make sure you turn on notifications so you can come talk about all of these offseason rumors with us. All right, so Chris Paul trade to the Lakers. It would make a lot of sense. Look, I mean, LeBron James and Chris Paul are good friends. Paul had an all-star season this year. He was an all-star, put up over 17 points and almost 7 assists per game this season. Showed that he still has a lot in the tank, despite being well into his 30s. So what would this deal look like in order to make it work? And I'll be honest, I thought for sure there was no way to make the salary cap math work to bring Chris Paul to the Lakers because his contract is just simply too big. But, I mean, Eric Pincus is the salary cap guru. This is the guy that's going to know if there's a way to make it happen. And this is what he says. He said that if you were going to make a deal for Chris Paul, you would have to include Danny Green, Kyle Kuzma, Quinn Cook, JaVale McGee, and Avery Bradley. And with those last two, McGee and Bradley, they would have to opt into their contracts and then be traded. They have player options for next season, so they would have to opt in. So that's a hurdle to clear right there. You would also have to shed the 28th overall pick in the NBA draft because that comes with guaranteed salary, and that could complicate things. So realistically, that would be the trade package. You'd be looking at those five players plus the 28th pick. Is that enough to get the Oklahoma City Thunder to bite? Well, maybe. I mean, it's a lot of savings. All of those contracts expire after this next season, so that could give them some savings, considering that Chris Paul still has 2 years remaining, and each of those years pay him more than $40 million. Yeah, that's a lot. But for the Lakers, it might be worth the risk to bring in Chris Paul, to bring in a third star. We know that has always been their plan, is to have a third star. Remember, at first, it was going to be LeBron, Paul George, and then the trade chips to send out for Anthony Davis. And then it was going to be LeBron, Anthony Davis, and Kawhi Leonard. And we heard rumors about, you know, Jimmy Butler, even bringing in a D'Angelo Russell. The blueprint has always included a third player. Obviously, this season, the Lakers didn't get that player. And things kind of worked out a little bit, didn't they, since they hoisted a 17th NBA championship. But still, if the opportunity pops up to bring in a good friend of LeBron's who happens to still be playing at an extremely high level and give them someone else who can handle the ball and take some of that burden off of LeBron James, maybe that's something that the Lakers will look into. Now, is this a realistic possibility? Well, according to Pincus, there is one Eastern Conference executive who believes that it can, and that executive said, Chris Paul would love to come back to LA. I know it would be a dream come true for Chris. I know LeBron loves and trusts him, and he would be a good fit. So it does sound like there is a little bit of something to this. Maybe there's a little bit of smoke here suggesting that the Lakers could make a move to get Chris Paul. If Chris Paul wants that and LeBron wants that, have to imagine the Lakers would probably at least investigate whether or not it's a possibility. Now, I will say this, though. One of the things that the Lakers had this season, one of their big strengths, was their chemistry. And so if you're removing Danny Green and Avery Bradley and JaVale McGee, where that's three starters right there, then you're throwing in your top young player, really, in Kyle Kuzma, the one guy left over from the young core, the boy who lived, the guy not traded for Anthony Davis. You've got him going in there, too. Plus, you've got Quinn Cook's salary in there. That's a lot of the team. That is a big chunk of the squad that you are sending out to now bring in a veteran Chris Paul. Is that really a move that you want to make? Might that disrupt the chemistry on the squad. And then if you have a salary like Chris Paul, LeBron James, and Anthony Davis, who was reported later today, earlier today, does plan on re-signing with the Lakers. You have those three big salaries. How are you going to fill out the rest of your roster? It's not going to be easy. They're going to have to get creative in order to fill things out. They're going to have to bring back some guys that have bird rights, guys like Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And frankly, they would have to go fairly well into the luxury tax. So do the Lakers want to do that as well? A lot of things to figure out before just saying, yes, let's get this done. And on top of that, you got to ask if you're going to burn all of those assets. And the Lakers don't have very many trade assets. If you're going to send away all of those, is an aging Chris Paul really the guy that you want? And he was phenomenal last season. Take nothing away from him. The Thunder were overachievers last season. And there are some questions about, well, maybe the Thunder will finally decide to just kind of blow it up, trade away their assets, do everything they can to rebuild. We know they have a mountain of draft picks that they got from the Clippers. So might they look to move Chris Paul? That makes a lot of sense from their end. But if you're the Lakers and you're going to burn all those, wouldn't you rather go and find a younger player? Now, maybe that's not out there because that package, frankly, it doesn't have a lot of top end talent there. The number 28th overall pick, that's not much. That's not going to get you a lot. So you can definitely make the argument that, look, you're not getting, like, I don't know, a CJ McCollum or somebody in their prime, Damian Lillard, certainly. You're not getting any of those types of players. You're just not. You're not going to land them with that package. So Chris Paul, if you're going to bring in a third guy, might be your best shot, and you just have to take the risk with his age and hope that he holds up. I will say that it concerns me a little bit just because, if you remember, we saw an aging point guard come to Los Angeles about 16 years ago, a guy named Gary Payton. And he looked pretty good the season before he came to LA. And then as soon as he arrived here, well, the glove looked more like the mitten. And that didn't work out so well. So when age hits you, when you're a point guard, sometimes it hits you fast and it hits you hard. But again, Chris Paul being such a cerebral player, he has been able to be effective even as his athleticism wanes. But how much longer is that going to hold off? He is getting paid, again, north of $40 million each of the next two seasons. Does have a player option for that final season, but you have to imagine he's going to pick that up. So it would be a gamble for the Lakers. Make no mistake. I know trades are exciting. Trades are fun. Trades are sexy. All of that. But I don't know that it's the home run move for the Lakers, especially since their chemistry was such a key feature of the team this season. But again, if Chris Paul wants this, if LeBron wants this, the Lakers are probably going to, at the very least, investigate it. And talent-wise, on paper, man, I mean, Chris Paul, LeBron James, and Anthony Davis together, can't deny that sounds awfully good. Let me know what you guys think. Do you stick with the current team, let them run it back, and try to win a championship again, go back to back? Or do you make a big move like this and bring in a high-priced player like Chris Paul and try to improve your overall talent level? Let me know your thoughts. Fire them off in the comments down below. And don't forget, follow Lakers Nation across social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. And if you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram. Till next time, see ya and stay safe.